Yo dudes, what's up? This is Planet Keef, I'm Keef, and today I'm going to do something, well, I'm going to try something a little bit different. I'm not working on a project, actually I'm working on about 10 projects simultaneously, as you know, I never get any finished, but I'm just going to talk at you. Now, I used to do this in the beginning of this channel when it was called Keef Talks, and it was like semi-scripted and actually pretty hard work and yeah. So I knocked that on the head, but this is pretty much unscripted. I've just got a list of topics and I'm just going to tell you about things that have been going on in the last week. So it hopefully could be a weekly thing if I can, you know, squeeze it into my schedule. I was going to shoot this yesterday, Sunday afternoon, but the sun came out and so did all the kids, and they've been sort of locked away for quite a while, so it was like, you know, a little cluster bomb exploded. All these small earthlings playing football and screaming and shouting and having a great time. So, you know, Mr. Grumpy, well, I'm doing it now. It's Monday, so I'm pretending it's Sunday. So I won't tell you what I saw this morning or anything about today, except I'm here doing it. Okay. Witchering, that's what I'm doing, I'm witchering. It's been an interesting week. It started, well, especially weather-wise, this being Britain, we had proper spring weather, which means all four seasons, usually in one day. We had a couple of days of very hot sunshine. That might have been the week before, but yeah, maybe it was, well, I don't know. Anyway, in the low 20s Celsius, which is, you know, scorchio for Yorkshire, it doesn't get a lot hotter than that. I love it. But then a few days later we had snow. A couple of days of snow. One of the days it settled proper. Also yesterday, Sunday, we had an unexpected flurry of hail. And still didn't stop the kids playing. But yeah, it's just been mad, mad, mad. But the main news of the week is that things keep breaking. Our world's sexiest kettle, Mark II, that broke a couple of weeks ago and we had to get replacement. And Mrs. Planet says she would choose it because, you know, I always go for the glass ones, which they're okay till they start scaling up and then they don't look great. So now we've got just an ordinary stainless steel jug kettle. Which is fine, it's fine, except the controls to open the lid and switch it on are reversed from what I'm used to. So every time I go to switch it on, I open the lid. I expect I'll get used to that just in time for us to have to buy another one. Yeah, also things keep breaking. My inkjet printer decided that after 5 years of faithful service, it wasn't going to do any more. I wouldn't mind, but I only just bought ink cartridges about a month ago. But it's got, when you switch it on, you get the error light is just on. It's not flashing. If it was flashing, that would tell you what the problem was. It can flash any number of times, up to 17, and each one of those has a different meaning. But if it's just on, Canon have nothing to say about that. Other people do have something to say about that, and it goes something like, it's knackered. So, here we go, built-in obsolescence. Well, maybe it's not, 5 years is okay. And it was a very, very cheap printer. It only cost, I don't know, about £30. Because this is the thing with printers, you're not paying for the printer, you're paying for the ink. The ink costs a fortune. So, as soon as I've got some pennies, I'm going to get a replacement where you subscribe to the ink, and I'll tell you more about that next week when I've done it. So that's two things that are broke, and a third thing that's broken is this beast. Well, it's not a beast. It's a Zoom H1 digital audio recorder. Basically, it's your digital tape recorder. So first of all, the battery compartment cover won't. It's lost something. Something snapped off, so it won't stay closed. But worse than that, you put a battery in, and I know that's a fresh battery and I've tested it, it's full of juice, but it will not power the device. So that's useless. However, it can be powered by a funny shaped USB socket plug. And I've got a few of those, because if you ever buy an Arduino, it'll come with a little cable like this, and it will be this long, which is no good. So then I had to buy a 2 meter extension cable for that to power this when it's up over my head. So that was okay for one video. I was going to use it for this one, and when I switched it on, it won't read the card, the memory card. It just doesn't recognize that it's there, and so it won't let you record anything. So I am annoyed about that, because I mean, I don't actually like this machine. I don't like the way it's designed. I don't like the switch, the way the switches work. I just don't like it. But a new one, and it won't be a Zoom, because, well, it just won't. I mean, I just don't like the way they design their products. But whatever it is, will cost at least £100, which right now I don't have. So I'm back to the Rode mic, which has been, well, the mic hasn't been given problems, but the extension cable to connect it to the camera up to 3 meters away has developed a buzz. But I've found a way to maybe reduce that buzz. Anyway, serious whittering. I am annoyed at the, well, I've always been annoyed at the concept of stuff not lasting forever, and the other concept of stuff being deliberately engineered not to last forever. Because if you do that, and I said I won't buy another Zoom on principle, because this should last forever, I shouldn't have to buy another digital audio recorder. And I have taken to keeping receipts and things these days, just in case something breaks while it's still in warranty. The new kettle, by the way, has a 3-year warranty, so we'll see how that goes. We've watched some good stuff on the telly this week. I don't normally like to watch more than 1 or 2 hours of TV per night. There's other things to do, and I generally just fall asleep on the sofa if I'm on it for too long, so that's a waste of time. What we were looking forward to was the finals week of MasterChef, which is always, you know, pretty gripping. You've got down to the last four and then the last three, and they are absolute genius level cooks by this stage, and there's very little to choose between them, and it's all down to, you know, do they cut their finger on the night? So that's something that I've been looking forward to for weeks. Then another thing we've started watching is This Is My House. This is a series on BBC One, hosted by Stacey Dooley, in which four unknown to us people are in this, you know, usually quite smart house, and they all claim that it belongs to them. And there's a panel of celebrities who ask them questions and try to figure out who actually lives in that house. And they're not actually very good at it so far, because the contestants are excellent liars. And it sounds totally balmy, but it's actually brilliant, brilliant stuff. So, yeah, I look forward to that. Oh, finally, an old bloke died on Friday, Prince Philip. The Queen's husband, 99 years old, he's just had a month in hospital. It wasn't entirely a surprise. But, well, the BBC just went completely overboard. They cancelled all of their programmes on that night, that day, and that night, and the next morning. 24 hours, rolling coverage of just people say, oh, he was a great bloke, isn't it sad? On BBC One and BBC Two, and they also cancelled all local radio stations, all the different radio stations playing the same thing. And, well, talk about overkill. they even had to set up a special complaints form on their website to just to handle the sheer volume of people saying that we don't want wall-to-wall coverage of this on all your channels. It's just completely unwarranted, and it is. But this is the pressure that the BBC are under from the government, who, you know, basically want them to go away and die. Sorry, that was a bit political. I'm not doing politics on this channel, okay? Also, we watched a film, The Avengers Assemble, which is one of the Marvel Cinematic Universe movies that we've kind of avoided or just missed, just haven't watched any of them. And it was brilliant. Absolutely loved it. So that's opened the door to you know, a couple of dozen films that we might watch in the future. However, what I wanted to watch on Friday night was the final of MasterChef, but it was cancelled because some bloke died. And BBC haven't actually, as of yet, said when it will be shown. So that's annoying. But things are looking up. We're into stage two of unlocking the lockdown on Monday. That's today, but I'm not talking about it. Which means that non-essential shops and hairdressers can open. And yes, I'll be paying a visit this week, I think. I haven't actually made a booking because blokes don't do that, but we'll see. Right, so that was 15 minutes of non-stop wittering. I think you've had enough. I know I have. So so you take care, and I'll try and do this again next week when more interesting stuff will have happened. Thanks for watching. See you next time.